Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll be sharing with you my own method of cooking egusi soup, and especially with an unusual but healthy type of vegetable. Trust me, this soup can marry just anything marryable. So if you would like to check out my method of cooking this egusi soup, come along with me. The ingredients I'll be using for this recipe are grinded egusi, onions, meat, crayfish, smoked fish, pomo, locust beans, palm oil, rodo and tatashe, and then seasoning. I also have my salt to taste and my special kind of vegetable, which is osito tufa. Okay, now the first step is for me to boil my meat. I already washed them. I'll be adding my onions. My seasoning and my salt. I'll be adding a little of my Cameroon pepper. Just a little water to get it cooked, because I'll be needing this stock. This should cook for about 15 to 20 minutes. Right now my meat is cooked, and I'll just bring them out and continue with the process. I'll be heating my oil, then I'll add my chopped onions. And allow it fry for just about a minute or two. Right now I'll add my egusi paste, which I already made by blending my onion with the grinded egusi, and stir consistently. I'll be cooking this on a medium heat, because this process has to be done carefully to avoid having burnt offering. I'll keep stirring until the egusi starts to form pebble-like shape. This may take a little while. Now this is the feel I want. It has formed the pebble-like mixture. So at this stage, I'll be pouring my grinded rodo tatashe and onion mixture. So now I'll keep stirring until all ingredients are well combined. Let me tell you something, if you don't like stirring, then maybe this method is not for you. This is because the constant stirring protects the soup from getting burnt, yet achieving your desired result. So now I'll be adding my meat stock, cooked meat, deboned smoked fish, my pomo, my grinded crayfish, and stir properly. Right now I will add my locust beans. Although this is optional, I just like using it in most of my soup for its health benefit, and especially the aroma it gives to my cooking. Note that I haven't added my seasoning or salt. This is because the meat stock already has all of that. So I want all the ingredients to get combined properly before tasting to see if the seasoning is okay or may need an adjustment. I'll leave this to cook for about 2 to 3 minutes and continue with the process. I just added a little seasoning and salt to perfect the taste. Okay, I mentioned earlier that the vegetable I'll be using for this egusi soup is called osito tufa. Have you heard about this vegetable before? Honestly, Africa is blessed when it comes to food and herbs. This vegetable is also called Iyanopaja in Yoruba, and the botanical name is called Jatropha tangerensis. It has been washed, so I'm just going to add it to my egusi soup. The leaves are said to be used traditionally in the treatment of anemia, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases. It also possesses blood replenishing properties and are rich in anti-cancer agents, anti-anemic, antiplasmodial and antioxidant effect against oxidative stress induced by malaria parasites. Please Google it and explore more of the goodness in this vegetable. Guys, I'm adding a little bit of bitter leaf into my juicy soup. I just like to always have bitter leaves added to my vegetable soup, always, because I feel it's a sweet soup, especially this egusi soup, and the bitter leaves just balances its sweetness, sort of. Stir the vegetables very well and then leave to simmer for 2 minutes. Right now my egusi soup is done. This is my most preferred method of cooking egusi soup. Guys, just take a look at this goodness. My vegetables are still very green and my soup is ready. Guys, I'm salivating already. What would you have this egusi soup with? Please let me know in the comment section. Also, I want you to give it a try and let me have your feedback on it.